I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all of you. We are aware that we have in our midst members of the community, members of Univen Radio, members of staff, and students. And we are aware that there were a number of things that you could have been doing, but you decided to set time aside to come and be with us to be part of the Univen Radio Annual General Meeting. So we really appreciate that, and we'd also like to invite you to actively participate in the deliberations. And your presence, as I've indicated, means a lot to us. And I think it's also worth indicating that Univen Radio is one of the radio stations within our district, which is doing very well in a number of things, including listenership. We are one of the radio stations within the district.
This is a gathering in which is a requirement by ICASA and other stakeholders in the communication department that we have to have this kind of gathering whereby we are going to have an elective meeting through general meetings. These kind of meetings, you know, take place, you know, once per year, whereby the station will be taking you through its programs, telling you how far are we as the station and the challenges thereof.
And guide the station in its daily operational activity through availability of policies. Those policies are as follows: marketing and sales, music policies, programming policies, news policies, human resource policies, and administration. Then the second one, we supported the call for management to send an application for the amendment of broadcasting hours and radius, after which ICASA authorized the station to broadcast 24 hours. I think we can clap hands for that. With regard to the station finances, we advised the expenditure, we advised that the expenditure has reduced in future to avoid and
so that affects our income of 642,975. It decreased that to the balance of 420,972 income for the year 2016. We go down to the operational expenses.
We made an application to obtain new broadcasting equipment. We've received positive feedback. We're still awaiting an agreement from MDDA to be signed from the university so that they can install new broadcasting equipment for the radio station. We've been using analog equipment since 1997 up until today. But still, we are still able to broadcast to our community. With regards to human resource, the station saw some changes within its management team in that Ms. Kakarani Mwaba, our new secretary, Mr. Justice Masekane, and Mr. Patwani Chitetete ended their contracts with the station. And also to the non-management members, Mr. Maschepan Nzepe, Mr. Tinyiko Makubele, Mr. Paila Chauke, Mr. Mawunga, Mr. Justice Mukwengo, Mr. Stanley Sikita, Ms. Rasimpi, and Mr. Karan Makuya and Ms. Umberani Nechandama also left the radio station. And in addition, was made to the station's management, and the appointment of Mr. Justice Shipalana was done, who is working as the assistant media and sound broadcasting
officer.
Maybe the community radio station was involved in. How did those events go? What is our plan? Maybe in the foreseeable future. So I just thought maybe I would see a lot of detail in terms of community engagement.
Una income na the operational expenses. Mara under the operational expenses.
For me, it's not a question. It's rather like a comment with regard to the issue of content.
It's not a comment. The way the radio station and the control of the Kushmazon, So, but that's what comes to the right. There's a manaka.
Or the Kavarish is the rest of the world. The Nerkova for Pair, or the Vadoshum, Zabu, the Buddhi, Bada Dana Tabrozash, or is to the Chimbi.